Hello everyone, I'm Alisha and welcome to the Google Play Policy Bytes India video series. Google Play policies are immensely important and are designed, keeping users at the heart of everything we do. We do not succeed until our partners succeed, and our policies aim to empower and encourage our developers to invest in their growth while ensuring that users have a trustworthy experience on Google Play. Now, let's talk about our best practices on user-generated content to help you build apps that truly delight users. User-generated content, that is UGC, is content that users contribute to an app. If your app falls under the UGC category, you will need to implement necessary moderation practices and reporting systems to ensure that users have appropriate safety and an optimum experience. Do remember that apps whose primary purpose is featuring or hosting objectionable UGC, they will be removed from the Google Play Store. Let's now go over our UGC policy requirements. Apps that contain or feature UGC must require that users accept the app's terms of use or user policy before users can create or upload UGC. The app should define objectionable content and behavior in a way that complies with Play's developer program policies and prohibit them in the app's terms of use or user policies. Your app must implement robust, effective, and ongoing UGC moderation, as is reasonable and consistent with the type of UGC hosted by the app. The app should provide an in-app system for reporting objectionable UGC and users, and take action against that UGC or user where appropriate. Your app must provide an in-app system for blocking UGC and users. The app should provide safeguards to prevent in-app monetization from encouraging objectionable user behavior. Next, let's look at acceptable functionality for user-generated content or UGC moderation system, including the in-app reporting system. In the case of augmented reality apps, also referred to as AR apps, UGC moderation, including the in-app reporting system, must account for objectionable augmented reality UGC, such as a sexually explicit AR image, and sensitive AR anchoring location, for example, an AR content anchored to a restricted area, such as a military base or a private property, where AR anchoring may cause issues for the property owner. Notice the screenshot to your left. It covers both how to report sexually explicit images and also how to report content anchored in sensitive location. This is a specific way to report this information and is preferred. But as seen on the screenshot on the right, the reporting tool can be specific or non-specific to report sensitive location, as long as it allows the user to conduct in-app reporting for objectionable content or location anchor. Here are some examples of common violations of UGC policy. Apps that promote sexually explicit UGC, including implementing or permitting paid features that principally encourage the sharing of objectionable content. Secondly, apps with UGC that lack sufficient safeguards against threats, harassment, or bullying, particularly towards minors. Next is posts, comments, or photos within an app that are primarily intended to harass or single out another person for abuse, malicious attack, or ridicule. And lastly, apps that fail to report and block objectionable content and users and continually fail to address complaints about objectionable content and users. Please note, all of this is not allowed. We hope you found this video useful and have learned more about the UGC policy. Thank you for continuing to partner with us to help build Google Play as a safe and trustworthy platform for users across the world. We are committed to helping you grow your businesses safely and deliver the best quality experiences for your users. Be sure to check out the free courses on Google Play Policy and remember to visit our Google Play Academy. Thank you for watching, and until next time, stay safe and stay healthy.